four, three, two.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of DW Daniel TV, your source for news and information here at DW Daniel. Today we're doing things a little different. We have 7 mini segments for you guys this week. We're going to start off with talking to the Teacher of the Year, Ms. Tapper. We're here with Ms. Tapper. How long have you been at Daniel?
My family moved to South Carolina in 2017, so I have been here this is the 6th year.
What was your journey like before you came to Daniel?
Before coming to Daniel, I had done a lot of different things. So there's part of my life I worked in retail, at bookstores, and different stores like that. I also worked as a counselor and a personal support worker. And let's see, I did work in some other schools doing some different things with behavior intervention and things like that. And finally got here to Daniel.
Why did you choose to teach math?
Actually, math kind of chose me. When I first came to Daniel and was working in the attendance office, there was a situation where Daniel needed a math teacher, and I was able to fill in for a bit in that position. After that, I used an alternative certification program in order to get my teaching certification, and was able to fill in with a need at Daniel, and math was where it was at.
How does it feel to be Teacher of the Year?
Well, being Teacher of the Year at Daniel High School is such a great honor because there are a lot of great teachers at Daniel High School. I love my students, so having the opportunity to spend days with students is just a privilege to me, and I want to keep learning so I can get better and better.
Well, congratulations, Ms. Tapper. Now let's go see what Danny and Maddie have for us.
Wow, thanks Maze and Sydney. Now I can trick or treat later.
You know what comes with Halloween? Candy.
I asked some students and teachers some would you rather questions. Candy edition.
Let's check it out.
Would you rather eat 50 Snickers or 50 Reese's?
50 Reese's.
50 Reese's.
Reese's for sure.
Probably 50 Reese's if they're frozen.
Would you rather eat candy for the rest of your life as every meal of the day, or never have dessert again?
Probably never have dessert again.
I would never have dessert again. Too much candy.
Never eat dessert again because I'm not a big candy person anyways.
Would you rather have your house made of Laffy Taffy or Twizzlers?
I'd have to say Twizzlers because they're probably a little more sturdy.
Laffy Taffy.
Probably Laffy Taffy. But I love Twizzlers too, but I mean, the Laffy Taffy's gonna be stronger than Twizzlers.
Laffy Taffy. I feel like it'd be a stronger material.
Man, even I had a hard time answering those questions.
You know, I thought it was pretty sweet. Well, that's about it for this segment.
Hey, Sean, Hannah, catch!
What a Danny! Oh my gosh, that candy came as fast as these rapid-fire trivia questions that we just did. We had two Daniel students compete against each other with a series of rapid-fire trivia questions. Let's see who won.
Welcome to rapid-fire trivia, Halloween edition. Might be a little spooky. Hold on. Rules are simple. You have 10 seconds to answer each question. You know, once that 10 seconds is over, then we move on to the next question. Simple as that. Wrong answers do not deduct away points. Well, the right answers do give you each 1 point. Everything clear so far?
Yeah.
Whoever gets the most questions answered correctly wins. If there is a tie, we will use our overtime turkey tie toss-up question.
What is it?
You'll find out if there's a tie. Let's get started. How do pumpkins grow?
Seed? Out of the ground.
By vine. 0 points so far. What's the most popular candy bought on Halloween?
Candy corn. Yeah, candy corn.
Quiet, Raul. Only one holiday has more consumer sales than Halloween. Which one is it?
Christmas.
1 point for Andrew. What's the most successful horror movie according to the box office?
Scream. Jason.
Leatherface.
No, it's it. Which song came out first? Monster Mash or One-Eyed, One-Horned, Flying Purple People Eater?
That one.
Monster Mash.
No, it's One-Eyed, One-Horned, Flying Purple People Eater. What's the average number of pieces of given out of pieces of candy given out per house?
Four.
Three. Two.
Two. Two. Two. Raul. Who's the killer in the famous movie Halloween? We are out of time.
Michael Myers.
We are on to the turkey toss tie question.
Buddy, the last one?
No, you ran out of time. Now, each of you will guess. There is not a specific time given to these questions. Whoever gets closer to the right number wins the whole thing.
Is it just one question?
The stakes are up here. How many turkeys are used for Thanksgiving each year in the United States?
600 million.
555 million.
Well, both of you are very, very off. It's only 46 million, but Andrew is our winner.
Yeah.
Man, that was such a competitive game. I'm so glad I got to host that.
So, Anna, what's your favorite scary movie?
I don't know if it's my favorite, but a good one that I've seen recently is Midsommar. What's your favorite scary movie?
What's your favorite scary movie?
I don't know.
Probably It, because clowns are deeply terrifying and,
you know. The Shining.
Why?
Yes.
Minions.
Why?
Minions.
Those Conjuring movies with like Annabelle in them are probably my favorite scary movie.
Probably the third Conjuring.
Probably Conjuring 3.
I don't really watch a lot of scary movies even though I want to, but I like the Conjuring because we watched it together. They were really stupid in the movie and I thought it was really funny. Thank you. You didn't answer the question.
My favorite scary movie is The Conjuring because it's like really scary. Like I like cried the first time I watched it, so that's how you know it's good.
Awesome!
Okay, here you go.
The Spooky Buddies. Those dogs get me every time.
Either The Grudge or The Ring. It's just like really scary. Just her crawling out the, you know, TV or the well. Just scary.
My favorite scary movie, going for complete scary, is the very first Halloween movie.
Probably right now Scream, but it like Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the first one. Yeah.
My favorite scary movie is The Sixth Sense. I really like scary movies that are scary and make you think.
Yeah. Thank you.
The Chainsaw Massacre, because a dude rips some mom's head off and wears it. And it's kind of funny, honestly, in my opinion. M&M's.
What?
I got two.
That the second Conjuring.
The Saw movie.
It's terrifying.
It's gory.
Thank you.
Oh. Let me get one more.
Hope, what's your favorite scary movie?
I really like Scream.
Hello, my name is Jeremy, and today we went and asked students their biggest pet peeves, and then afterwards we bothered them with it.
Biggest pet peeve?
I would have to say when people start putting up Christmas decorations in September, makes me pretty mad.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
I don't like Hannah Leary.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
Slow walkers. I literally cannot stand.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
Loud chewers.
That's awful. I don't like those people either.
Me either.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
I'd say when people sing Jingle Bells randomly.
Jingle Bells, Jingle Bells.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
When people bite on ice, like just with their teeth, and it just hurts my mouth. Like, it just don't hurt my mouth.
Ah, I messed up.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
Chewing with your mouth open.
That's awful.
It is. Quit chewing.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
You.
Rude?
My biggest pet peeve is people being late to class. Speaking of being late, let's go find Dayton.
Anyways, today was anything but a backpack day here at Daniel, so let's go see what some students brought.
Me rolling, they hating, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty, trying to catch me riding dirty.
Okay, so what did you bring in today?
I have my my disc golf catcher.
A wheelchair. I brought my BMX bike.
Carved a pumpkin and I just hollowed it out and brought this as my backpack.
I brought in my dad's bear rug.
And what made you come up with this idea?
I like disc golf.
I was walking in my house and then I tripped on it. So I just said, yeah, it's a good idea.
Just walking out the house this morning and I was like, oh yeah, I was like, it is, bring anything but a book bag to school. And I see my bike, so I just put it in the car.
Well, we had a few pumpkins like outside decorating for fall and I was like, why not carve it and then just put my stuff inside?
I just thought it was super original and I thought it'd be funny, so that's really what I did.
So overall, students brought some really hilarious things for Anything But a Backpack Day, and this has been my favorite thing that Daniel's ever done for a Spirit Week. But hold on. Hello? Mom, you cannot call me when I'm doing DWD TV. You're cutting out.
Hello? Okay. Anyways, there's a good song for every occasion. So Alyssa went out to see what y'all's favorite songs are for different occasions.
Okay, what is your go-to song for a late night cookout run?
Big Things Poppin', Little Things Stoppin' by T.I.
What's your go-to song for a late night run to cookout?
Right now, Best Friends by Rex Orange County.
Wu-Tang. Can you sing it?
You know it.
Go-to song for late night drives and cookout is "Achy Breaky Heart" by Veggie Tales. Your go-to song for Christmas?
The Christmas song. It's really good. It's actually really good. I recommend it.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Jack Frost
tiny tots. What's your go-to song for Christmas?
Jingle Bells.
What's your go-to song for a breakup?
Never Forget You.
What's your go-to song for the last day of school?
Pick You Up by Foster the People.
Do you want to sing it for us?
No, thank you.
Alright, are we ready?
Yeah.
Our go-to song on the last day of school is Chattahoochee.
No Hands. If you need a hype song, I recommend that one.
By Waka Flocka Flame?
Yes.
Okay, what's your go-to song before a game?
How Far I'll Go, Moana. Gets me really hyped up.
What's your go-to song for a family road trip?
What's My Name by Brianna.
Can you sing it for us?
Oh, Nana, what's my name?
What's your go-to song for a late-night drive?
Chicago by Flip Turn. Thanks for watching this episode of DWD TV. Have a great weekend!